Will Propecia halt the hair loss immediately? Starting on half of Propecia daily, considering upping the dosage to a full tablet after 8 weeks. Just want to know, will my hair loss be halted almost immediately? Basically, the hair I have on my head now will, hopefully if I respond to the medication, be the hair I have in a year's time from now. Also, on one of my other posts on here, the trichologist said that if I continue to only take half a Propecia tablet, it won't stop shedding entirely, unlike that of a whole tablet. Thanks in advance.
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a question without a photo showing your current situation with your hair, but as your question describes, you're starting Propecia, but you're starting at half a dose initially, thinking of increasing it to the full dose at 8 weeks. And your question is about when will the Propecia take effect? Will it work immediately? And you're asking more information regarding the relative benefit of Propecia. Well, certainly I can address your question, and I think I have some understanding as to why you're doing what you're doing. Just a little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. Hair loss treatment, specifically hair transplant, has been a significant part of my practice. And in fact, I'm the founder of hair regeneration centers called TrichoStem Hair Regeneration. This is a treatment that we developed in our practice as both a non-surgical alternative to hair transplant, as well as what has become an alternative to taking oral finasteride for people who don't want to take it or cannot take it. And so the counseling of patients about finasteride has become a big part of my daily routine in our practice. So before I get into details about hair regeneration, let's just understand a few things about finasteride. First of all, when you take finasteride, the dosage was developed based on a certain basis of relative efficacy in the ability to diminish the amount of DHT. So if you think about it, taking half a dose can be compared to like taking half a dose of an antibiotic when you need a full dose. So I don't think that in itself is such a great plan. It might reduce approximately 60-70% of your DHT, so it's not necessarily one-to-one in terms of the effectiveness. But we also have to think about the relative likelihood of it being of benefit to you. Although a lot of men do respond to finasteride, and the numbers vary depending on the study you read, but I would say that it helps probably somewhere around 60%, and this is also from studies, and some would say up to 90%. But the point is that not everyone responds to finasteride. And there's only one way to tell, which is by taking it at the prescribed dose on a daily basis. Now, there has been a lot of concern about not only the effectiveness, but also when it comes to the compliance, that is actually a major issue when it comes to the management of hair loss. It has been shown that a lot of men may take finasteride with consistency in the first year, but a lot stop taking it in the second year, and there's a whole lot of reasons, and that's from clinical studies. From my own clinical practice, I can tell you that I've started a lot of people in finasteride, and they've been taking it since the beginning, since I started prescribing it sometime around 1997. They will take it every day for their whole life, and they will have no problems. But I would say a significant percentage will take it for a while, not take it, maybe think about taking it, and just be very sporadic, and essentially, they will not enjoy the benefit if they are responsive. And in fact, the original studies with finasteride had to be stopped early because the benefit was clearly there, and the people who were receiving the placebo were not benefiting. Now, when you started those same people who were on the placebo on finasteride again, they didn't catch up to those who were taking it from the beginning. So the hair counts matter, the hair inventory matters. Now, currently the biggest concern about finasteride is the potential of side effects related to short-term and long-term sexual side effects. In our practice, we counsel people on the effectiveness of an alternative we developed called hair regeneration. Hair regeneration was developed out of our working on patients with hair transplant using a material called extracellular matrix combined with platelet-rich plasma, which is derived from your own blood, that is essentially the growth factors and healing factors. The idea was to help our hair grafts heal better and the donor area to heal better. Well, what evolved from that was that thinning hair appeared to get thicker in different ways at different levels for different patients. So I took it upon myself to develop process and system so that we can, in the absence of doing a transplant, just do an injection. This injection has been so effective that both men and women with androgenetic or male and female pattern hair loss will have 99% success, defined by stopping of progression of hair loss, reactivation of hair that's not growing, and the shedding of thinning hair and the regrowth of thicker hair. Patients come to our practice from all over the world because of this, and we've actually developed a company called TrichoStem Hair Regeneration, and we're trying to scale this so that people can get this treatment outside of our two offices. The point is that when you think about the way we developed hair regeneration was based on a very methodical process. I customized the dosage, the delivery system, and developed an algorithm based on gender, age, level of hair loss, onset, a whole bunch of parameters, and I dose it appropriately, and in fact, even every single injection is dosed specifically with that algorithm in mind. So going back to finasteride, I think you need to make a decision on whether or not you want to stick with it, and if you're going to stick with it, do the right dose, and then see if it's effective. Discuss this with your doctor. And as far as the onset of benefit, typically you have to wait at least 3 to 6 months to see any benefit. And those who respond do pretty well within that time frame. The responsiveness is also dependent on growth cycles, on hair growth cycles, and the amount of hair shedding. Sometimes one of the early signs of improvement is the diminishing of hair shedding, and then slowly the thickening of hair. So it's really a journey, whether it's hair transplant, finasteride, or even hair regeneration. You're looking at about a year's timeline. You always have to take the long view, and you have to be consistent when it comes to taking a medication every day. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. And thank you for your question.